Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the new topic from the paper number 13, that is inorganic chemistry. Here, paper number 13, okay, the name of the paper is inorganic chemistry. For same, that is equal to S6. Okay, now actually in the original syllabus, that is of a old syllabus, this paper number is lies into a paper number what? That is equal to what here? Here, that is the 9th paper here. But here, in order to extend here, the paper is called as a paper number 13 here, paper number 14, paper number 15 and paper number 16. Now, this is the paper and it concludes total equal to 5 topics. As far as corona is occurs in our Maharashtra, therefore there is a reduction in syllabus. Therefore the topic is ruled out, that is topic is deleted, that is equal to a iron and steels, that is this topic is not present for our study. Total topic, how many remaining there are topics, and we have to cover these topics. First is named as coordination chemistry. Okay. In this coordination chemistry, there are two parts. Okay. Now the first part A and second part is called as a B. This topic we have to going to a learn. Okay. This A part is teaching by me, that is equal to PSK, and this B part is teaching by you, that is a Desai man. Okay. That is the thermodynamics, kinetics of a coordination complex. This topic will be, you have to learn from this Desai ma'am. And your first topic, that is the inorganic reaction mechanism, this part, that is inorganic reaction mechanism, this part we are going to start here. Okay, just do not jumbling in these topics. That is, first topic is what? That is the coordination chemistry. It is divided into two parts, that is equal to A and B. First part is taken by me and second part is taken by this time. Okay, so let us start here. That is the first part. Here, inorganic, first we are going to write the name of the topic, that is coordination chemistry. Now, the basic and 50% part of this coordination chemistry already you are studying in your BSc part 2. In this BSc part 3, we have to study the first part of this topic, that is a inorganic reaction mechanism. Okay. Likewise, the organic reaction mechanism here also exists in case of coordination chemistry of a complex, of an octahedral complex. Here, the inorganic reaction mechanism we have to see. First basic part is what? That is, what is meant by a reaction mechanism? What is meant by a reaction mechanism? See here, what is meant by a reaction mechanism? The pathway of a reaction from reactants to products, is known as reaction mechanism. Okay, what is meant by this? That is the pathway of a reaction from reactant to products. Now, which are the pathways incoming? This first is formation of a activated complex. Second one is, that is the stereochemical changes. And third one is, that is the most important, that is the kinetic behavior. Behavior, that is the rate of a reaction. Okay. Now, according to these criteria, the inorganic reaction mechanism is divided into how many types? Two types. Which are the two types? See here. First of all, I will give you the classification. Then we will go for our respective point. First is inorganic reaction classification is equal to what? That is nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is also called as SN reactions. Okay. The second is electrophilic substitution reactions. Okay. In short, it is called as a SE. Now, as far as your syllabus is concerned, here we have to concentrate on this nucleophilic substitution reactions. Okay. Not on here electrophilic substitution reaction, but there is a necessary thing is that, that is, you must know what is meant by nucleophilic substitution reaction. See the basic definition, that is nucleophilic substitution, the reaction in which ligand of a complex is replaced by, is substituted or replaced by, replaced by another ligand, the process is known as what? That is a nucleophilic substitution. What is this? That is the reaction in which the ligand of a complex is substituted or replaced by another ligand. Now, what is the electrophilic substitution? See here, this definition, that is a reaction in which of a metal complex a metal is replaced by another metal, it is called as a electrophilic substitution reactions. Now, what is our meaning of these two substitution reactions? That is, first is nucleophilic substitution reactions. Here, the substitution of a ligand, stress on here, just concentrate on this word, and electrophilic, there is a replacement of a metal here. Okay, now one by one we will discuss these reactions in detail. See here. First is about nucleophilic substitution reactions. Here, one point is noted to be that, that is, a ligand is replaced by another ligand. Okay, we have the general reactions, that is M alpha U X. Here, what is the step? That is, first is here M alpha U plus X. Okay, now this is the complex. I mean, how many ligands? That is, this is also ligand, this is also a ligands. Where M is called as metal ion. Okay, L is called as a ligand, X is called as a leaving ligand, ligand, and along with these ligands, how many ligands are attached to this metal ion? That is 6 ligands. Therefore, this is called as a coordination complex of a CN is equal to 6 here. Now, what is happens here? Here, first is dissociation of the bond between X ligand and M, and here formation of a which ML5, that is of coordination number is equal to 5, that is equal to a square pyramidal structure is formed. Now, what is our definition only here? That is the nucleophilic substitution reaction in which ligand is replaced by another ligand. Here, this is the first step. Now, what about the second step? When the another ligand is Y, that is, this is called as a entering ligand. Here, what is the definition along to this? That is, this is replaced from this, that is ML5 and Y. Here formation, that is CN is equal to 6. Okay, thus the definition is fulfilled. Actually, we are going to discuss it in detailed forms here. Now, nucleophilic substitution reactions are classified into two ways. First is SN1 reactions, second is SN2 reactions. Okay, we have to study here these inorganic reaction mechanism in the sequence of a SN1 and SN2 reactions. Formally, SN1 reactions is also known as a dissociative reaction mechanism. Okay, and in SN2 what? That is a association reaction mechanism. Now, one by one, in detail, we have to learn here the SN1 reactions. And why the SN1 reactions are called as a level reactions? This part we will consider in the next lecture. See, the first point, that is the SN1 reactions here. Now, SN1 means what? That is the unimolecular substitution, nucleophilic substitution reactions. Okay, what the meaning here? Okay, SN1 means what? That is unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now, why these reactions are called as a dissociative reaction mechanism, and what is the mechanism? See here. Now, first by taking the example, that is of a SN1 reactions. First one is a SN1 reactions. Okay, now let us start here for taking the example from here. See here. ML5X here dissociation, okay, that is a dissociation, that is slow step, okay, it is also called as a rate determining step. Now, before knowing the reactions, we can already see this meaning. Again, I am repeating this. Where M is called as metal ion, L is called as a ligand, and X is also called as a ligand, which is a what? That is a leaving one. Yeah. Okay. Now, here, the coordination complex of how many ligands are attached? 1 to 6. Okay. Now, this is of a octahedral complex. Octahedral complex here. Now, what is the dissociation state here? The bond between this metal ion and the leaving ligand is now breaks up. There is formation of ML5 plus X. Okay, That is the dissociation of a living ligand. We can again write as a dissociation of a living ligand. Okay, now here what is the remaining one? That is ML5. Originally how many ligands? 6. Now after dissociation, how many ligands form here? That is equal to 5. Therefore, coordination number is decreases to 1 unit. It is equal to 5. And this geometry is known as a square pyramid. Now, one of the discussing points is that, this step is also known as a dissociation step. Dissociation step. Here, in the formation of a SN1 reactions, what happens here? First is a dissociation step here, considered here. That is ML5X dissociates into a ML5+X. Here, as the step is very slow, that reaction is also called as a SN1 reactions, because here the concentration of the reacting species which we have considered, that is equal to what? ML5X. Okay, here that is one of the, this concentration is considered here. Therefore, this reaction is called as a unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now, what is the second step here? As far as second step here considered, what is the second step here? That is called as a association step. Association step, or it may be also called as a fast step. Now, as far as this ML5 is formed here, it may be of which? That is a square pyramid. It is of a intermediate. It is also called as a intermediate. Okay, it can have a short or long lived according to the, when we are discussing with the kinetic data. But what is the second step here? That is ML5 plus an entering ligand. Say it is a Y. This is called as a entering ligand. This is called as a fast step. And it's called as an association. And there is formation between a bond between, that is M and Y here. There is formation of, again, CN is equal to 6, that is of a octahedral complex. Octahedral here complex. Got it? And this is whatever may be the square pyramid, that is called as an intermediate, again forms a bond between this entering ligand. Entering ligand means what? That is a nucleophile. That is what? A nucleophile. And as we know, the nucleophiles are what? That is, they are electron donor one. They are also called as a Lewis passes also. Okay. Now one by one we have to cover this in short process as here. See here. In SN1 reactions. First point. How many steps are here? We have to just recognize this, that is first step is what? That is the dissociation step. Okay. And second step is what? That is the association step. I can write here reaction first. ML5X on dissociation here. That is a slow step here. Okay. There is formation of ML5+X, SP, that is square pyramidal, CN is equal to what? 5. Here CN is equal to what? 6. And here octahedral complex. Now, this is the first step. Well, now, what about the second step here? That is ML5+ entering ligand. There is formation of ML5+ into Y. CN is equal to again 6 here. Octahedral complex. Here this is the square pyramidal. CN is equal to 5. Now what is about Y? Here entering ligand. Okay, it is also called as a nucleophile. This step is called as a faster step. Okay, now what are the specifications of this SMM reactions? That is, in this reactions, the dissociation of a leaving ligand, their X is called as what? That is a leaving ligand. Ligand takes place, therefore this mechanism is also called as a dissociation mechanism. It is also called as dissociation mechanism. Okay, now what are its points here? First, that is, in this SMM reaction or dissociation mechanism, first step is dissociation, that is, the octahedral complex. On dissociation, there is formation of a square pyramidal structure of coordination number is equal to 5. It is called as an intermediate. Okay. Now, what is about this in second step here? That is, what is maybe this intermediate? When can form the bonds with an entering ligand, which is called as an nucleophile, there is formation of a coordination number is equal to again 6. Now, what is about this? This is a slow step. Therefore, here this step is called as rate determining step here. And as far as this association step, this is a fast step here also. Therefore, this step is also known as the association step here. Now, here this is the metal complex. This is a entering ligand, that is a nucleophile. And what are the specifications of nucleophile? They are electron donor. Okay. Second, yeah, they are Lewis bases. Okay, now what is about its kinetics? See, are the kinetics. Here, as far as kinetics of this SN1 reaction is considered, here the rate of a reaction. See here. Rate of a reaction is directly proportional to what here? That is the first reacting complex is, that is equal to ML5. Okay, therefore, rate of a reaction is equal to some constant is equal to K into ML5. Where K is called as proportionality constant, and ML5 is a complex. That is a intermediate. As the rate of a reaction depends upon the concentration of this one complex, therefore this reaction has concentration of rate of a reaction depends upon the concentration of reactant equal to 1. Therefore, the reaction is known as what? That is the SN1 reactions. Okay, now always keep in mind that is the dissociative mechanism is always nothing but the SN1 reactions. So as far as its graphical representation is considered, see here, graphical representation. That is, here E. Okay, this is. That is called as reaction coordinate. Okay, this state is called as reactant. This is called as a activated complex 1, AC1 here, AC of 2 here. Okay, and this is of this called as a products. Here it is called as an intermediate. Okay. Now, here we are going to discuss the reactions. What are meant by A, R? That is, R is equal to reactant. Here, I is equal to here intermediate equal to this is equal to I here, that is equal to M ln here. Okay, this is the activation state first, this is the activation state is equal to second here. Okay, A and C are the activated complex. AC 1 and 2. Now, see here. Here R is called as a reactants. Okay. And here P is called as a products. Okay. Now, as far as we have seen this, the area, this is area is equal to higher peak. That is, the reaction to be start from this, from reactant side, and it goes forward from this activated complex state. Here it requires the higher amount of energy, that is the reaction is in a which state, that is a rate determining state. Why? Because the peak from reactant to activated complex one, here this peak is broad and higher one, and the energy is required for this reactant to products is a higher one. That in a consider from this, what? That is from an intermediate to this activated state, this area is, and a high peak area is lower one, that is compared to this first peak area, that is from for an activated complex first one here. Therefore, this area is equal to a lower one and it requires a lower amount of a energy one. As far as this energy is considered here, that is equal to, again we have to write here, rate of a reaction is equal to K into concentration of M into ln. That is of an intermediate here. What is intermediate? That is MLN. That is from a dissociation of a MLNX. Here dissociated ligand is what? That is equal to X. And remaining intermediate is what? MLN. Okay, in this way we have here explained the graphical representation for a SN1 reactions. It is also called as what? It is a dissociative mechanism. Okay, I hope that all of you understand this part is in very well. If there are any problems, please ask me on group here. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss the next type of this inorganic reaction mechanism, that is of a second mechanism, that is called as an associative mechanism. Thank you.